Okay, welcome back everyone. If you're unfortunate enough to sit through either of my cleaning and polishing technique videos, you'll know that they were both abject failures. So if finesse and technique, if you can call it that, doesn't work, what's the answer? Brute force pressure washing, obviously. The question is, how much of the gel coat is going to survive? How much of the woodwork is going to survive? And how much of the non-slip paint will still be on the boat? You can see that the worst of the dirt, mildew stuff has built up by the tow rails, but actually the whole deck and superstructure is kind of covered in this weird sooty coloured coating. I guess really it was probably naive of me to think that I could begin using other cleaning techniques without first just running a pressure washer over the boat. And this is actually the first proper clean or wash Perichet has had in the 4 years we've owned it. Whoops. It should be obvious from the quick walk around tour that there isn't much of the non-slip paint left to start with, especially compared to when I first bought it, which I'll try and put up on screen now. So it's been happily falling off on its own for years already. So what have I got to lose? Not a lot really, other than maybe flooding the boat mildly. I'm not really up to speed with this whole ASMR thing, and this isn't really an attempt at doing that, but it is going to be a lot of pressure washing, which I know some of you boat cleaning sadists will probably enjoy, so here we go.
God.
Yeah.
Righto, it's a day or two after I did the pressure washing. Let's have a look at how it turned out. So we can see a lot of the non-slip paint has slipped off the boat. The pressure washer really did take that off quite aggressively. But in general, I think it's in a much better starting point now to either do a more thorough clean or just to leave it as is. Let's have a little look around. So these areas in particular were full of kind of mildew stuff. You can see the underlying condition of the gel coat itself isn't fantastic, but it certainly looks better than it did. The teak toe rails have actually come up quite nicely. I wasn't intentionally pressure washing them because I was worried about them disintegrating, but they were obviously getting a bit caught in the crossfire, but they seem to have well, they've certainly lightened up and look a lot cleaner, so that's one thing. Yeah. So, in general, looking like a much better place to start from. I'm very happy with it. I even blasted out the manky hole, and it seems to have dried out. I can see there's actually a drain hole at the bottom, so that must have been blocked up. That's good. That's really good.